Happy morning to all. Welcome to this English online session. Today's topic is transitive and intransitive verb. Dear students, let's go on to the topic transitive verb. What is a transitive verb? A transitive verb is a verb that speaks of an action which passes from the doer, that is subject, to the receiver, that is object. A transitive verb requires an object. It answers to the question what. Some transitive verbs are address, borrow, discuss, raise, offer, pay, write, promise, and have. Let's see some examples for transitive verb. See first one, Hina ate an apple. Here see verb ate. What tense? Ate, past tense. So we have to divide the verb did plus eat. To make question, we have to split the verb into auxiliary and main verb. Now ask question, what did Hina eat? Hina ate an apple. Say second question, I bought some wonderful books. Simply we can ask like this, I bought what? I bought some wonderful books. So if you ask question what, if you get answer means, that is transitive verb. Say third one, I understood her problem. I understood what? Her problem. Ramya draws a picture. Ramya draws what? A picture. So in the above sentences, ate, bought, understood, draws, these are transitive verbs. Next we have to see intransitive verb. An intransitive verb is a verb that speaks of an action which does not pass on to an object. It does not answer to the question what. Instead, it answers to the question why, when, where, and how. Intransitive verb does not take an object. Let's see examples for intransitive verb. See first one, Parul ran fast. Here what is verb ran? Fast adverb. So we have to ask question, how did Parul run? How did Parul run? Fast. So this one intransitive verb because it does not answer to the question what. See second one, they went to the market. For this we have to ask, where did they go? Where did they go? They went to the market. See third one, the children slept peacefully. Here this one adverb, so we have to ask question how. How did the children sleep? The children slept peacefully. So this also intransitive verb. Some intransitive verbs are go, come, die, sleep, fall, lie, live, happen, exist, snore, etc. Dear children, the words which is seen previously can only be used intransitively. This is because the actions described by these verbs cannot be passed on to an object. That means it does not answer to the question what. See example. First one, Jose lives in Kerala. Where does Jose live? In Kerala. So we ask the question where. Transitive verb means we have to ask question what. So this one intransitive verb. The old man snored loudly. How did the old man snore? Loudly. See third one, she fell down. Where did she fall? She fell down. So this also intransitive verb. Dear children, some verbs can be used only transitively because they always require an object. Examples of such verbs are merit, select, recognize,
admire, appreciate, etc. Some verbs that act both transitive and intransitive verbs. Shall we say what are the verbs?
Some verbs can be both transitive and intransitive depending on the situation. In some instances, such a verb may require an object, while in others, it does not require an object. Dear children, can we see how the verb continue can act both transitive and intransitive verb? See example, we will continue the meeting after the break. Here, continue that acts as transitive verb. Here we have to ask question, we will continue what? We will continue the meeting. So this one, transitive verb. Same verb, see in second sentence, the meeting continued after the break. The meeting continued what? We can't ask. Instead, we have to ask question, when did the meeting continue? So the meeting continued after the break. So this one here, intransitive. So according to the situation, the verb, same verb acts both transitive and intransitive verb. Let's see the function of play as transitive and intransitive verb. See, first question, three of the students play the guitar. Three of the students play what? The guitar. So this one, transitive verb. The same verb play in second sentence, the students will play outside today. For the second one, we have to ask question, where will the students play? Where will the students play? The students will play outside today, in transitive verb. Because after verb, outside is given. This one, place. So we have to ask question, where? So this is not transitive verb. Let's see the third verb, return. How it acts both transitive and intransitive verb. See, first one, Nitin returned the book to the library. Here, we have to ask question, Nitin returned what? What did Nitin return the book? So, here, return that verb acts as transitive verb. See, second one, the students returned to school after the winter break. Here, after verb, to school, that is the place. So, we have to ask where. Where did the students return? The students returned to school after the winter break. So, here, return, that verb acts as intransitive verb. So, according to the situation, we have to ask question. So, some verbs, they act both transitive and intransitive verbs according to the situation. For direct object, we have to ask question, what? That is transitive verb. Intransitive means we should ask the questions, when, where, how, and why. Place, time, reason, and we have to ask question, how? That is adverb. One more thing you should note down. In see first sentence, Nitin returned the book to the library. Where did Nitin return the book? We never ask question like this. After verb, we have to consider that word as answer. For that, we make question. See, in second sentence, the students returned to school after the winter break. Here also, that is we can question, possible question, when did the students return to school? But we never ask like that. Returned after to school. That only, for that word only, we have to ask question. So, here to school, there is a place. So, we have to ask question, where? Where did the students return to school? Dear children, most transitive verbs usually have one object. However, in some sentences where the verb has two objects, one is the indirect object and the other the direct object. So direct object answers to the question what, indirect object answers to the question to whom or for whom. Two types of object, direct object and indirect object. Direct object answers to what, indirect object answers to whom or for whom. See this example. First one, the teacher gave him a prize. The teacher gave what a prize. If you ask question what means, that is direct object. Gave to whom? To him. That is indirect object. So for sentences given means two objects there means we have to find out direct object and indirect object. Again remind you, for direct object we have to ask question what, for indirect object we have to ask question to whom or for whom. So this verb is here gave, transitive verb. Let's see the sentence. Please tell us a story. Here please tell what a story, that is direct object. Tell whom, to us, that is indirect object. So like that, so many sentences are there. For example, my mother bought me some fruits. In this sentence, my mother bought what? Some fruits. So that is direct object. To whom? To me. Me, indirect object. See next one. My uncle presented me a laptop. My uncle presented what? A laptop. To whom? To me. So a laptop, direct object. Me, indirect object. Dear students, today we discussed on transitive and intransitive verb. I hope you all understood clearly. We have to recall again, transitive verb answers to the question what. Intransitive verb does not answer to the question what. That's all. Very simple. So you have to make sentence of your own. You have to find out whether the verb is in transitive or intransitive. For transitive verb, you have to make sentences. For intransitive also, you have to make many sentences and recall again clearly. Thank you all.